Hello friends, welcome back to Tech Server Global channel. Hope you guys doing well. Today I'm going to discuss on Docker networking. This is another video on Docker series. In this video, our agenda will be what is Docker networking, Docker network drivers and the demo. So let's start with the what is that Docker networking. Docker networking allows you to create a network of Docker containers which has been managed by the master node. It also known as a manager. Container inside the Docker network can talk to each other by sharing the packets of information. As we know, containers are the light version of the virtual machine. In virtual machine, we used to create a virtual network in different virtualization technologies like ESXi, Hyper-V. Similar way, in Docker container, we are also using a Docker networking to create a communication between two containers. Docker network drivers. So these are the driver. Using driver, we can create a communication between two containers. So first driver is bridge. When you create a container without specifying any network or driver, by default it creates under the bridge, which is a default network type for any of the container. Second, host. Container will not have any IP address. They will directly created in the system. Network will remove the isolation between host and the container. It means it communicate using the host network, where there is no any kind of isolated network created in container. If you want to publish a port number using container, you can create a container and you can map with your local machine. But if you don't want to map and you want to access that particular service using your host IP address or host network, you can use a host driver. Third one is none. If you don't want to create a communication with local host or a container, you can simply use none, in which none of the IP address will assign to containers. These containers are not accessible from outside nor any other container. Overlay. Overlay network will enable the connection between multiple Docker daemons and make Docker swarm services communicate with each other. IPVLAN. Users have complete control over IPv4 and IPv6 addressing by using the IPVLAN driver. And last, MacVLAN. MacVLAN driver make it possible to assign a MAC address to container. Now let me navigate to my blog, which I have written on the Docker network only. So first we'll discuss on the Docker bridge network. So by default, this mode is enabled for all the containers and they communicate with each other using private IP address. Now, whenever we create a container, it will automatically have one private IP address, and that particular private IP address is from 172.70.0.0. If you want to access from outside, you need to map port number with your host. As we already discuss and already see this on the previous videos where we just mount or map port number from container to localhost. When you run the any container, default breach mode is enabled. So simple, when you run the command called docker run ubuntu, it will automatically create a machine or a container with docker breach network. So let me navigate to my PowerShell. First, let me check any container is running or not. No container is running, nor any stopped. Now let me create two container. So I have one example. I will create two container with name frontend and backend, and then I will try to communicate from frontend to backend using the private IP address. I'm not going to assign any network nor pass any additional variable or environment thing on the container. So let me create two container, and I'm going to use nginx as a container image. Let me run the command container docker run hyphen itd hyphen hyphen name frontend and nginx latest. Now run same command with the backend. Now if I run the command docker ps-a, you can find two containers with frontend and backend. Now let me open one more console. Now let me enter into the backend. exec-it backend /bin/bash. Now I am into my backend node. Now first I am going to run command like I just want to need a IP address. So let me navigate to another shell. I need IP address of the frontend container. So to get the details, command is docker inspect and the container name. Here you can see all the details regarding the container, in which you can find network and it's a breach network, and the gateway of the IP gateway of the container is 172.17.0.1 and the IP address is 172.17.0.2. Now from backend machine, I'm currently on the backend machine. Let me ping to frontend. Let me run the command ping 172.17.0.2. As I'm using nginx container image, where usually the ping command is not being installed. So for that, I'm going to first update the packages apt-get update. So here one more reason is to this container is having the internet connectivity is we can able to update the packages, right? When I run the command apt-get-update, it tried to get a live repository list. Now let me install apt-get install iputils-ping. And let me run command -y. So this will install a ping utility. Now let me run this command. So I can ping from front end, from backend container to front end. So simply I didn't pass any of the additional parameters to define the container network. So by default, all the containers are the part of the bridge. Similar to in this example, when you create any container, it will be part of our default bridge network. Now let me run one more container. Docker run -d --name, let say no network. I'm just adding my container name with the no network, and I'm putting network say none, and put the image name as nginx latest. Now your question is, how can I identify the network name should be the none? To get the list of the network, you can run command docker network and ls. By default, three network driver will be created. With first one is bridge, second one is host, and third one is none. So let me create with the none. Let me copy this command. Now let me run docker ps, and I'm trying to enter into exec, or else first inspect it whether any IP address is assigned to the no network container or not. Let me check that. So here network is none, gateway and IP address is none. Okay. Now let me enter into container. No network /bin/s. Now let me update the package apt-get update. Since if the package being downloaded, then this container must have the internet, but as per our expectation, it should not download or getting the packages from the internet, because we define a none network to this container. So let me run. So here you can see failed to fetch the URL and temporary failure resolving this dev.debian.org. That means this container is not having any IP address, nor it communicate with external sources using bridge network, because we use a none as a network driver. So let me exit it. Now let me docker network ls. Now we are going to create one more host or container using host. So how host will work? So for example, when you want to run the URL from the external network using the public IP address, you need to map a port number using bridge. But when you want to access container using the base machine IP address, you can use a host where container is not having any IP address, but it's been communicate using this your local machine host. Okay, so let me create one more container. Let me run the container. And I'm not going to put as a detached mode. I'm just running mode. Network is not none. It's host. So here you can see no network is already used by container. So let me change the name of the host network. I'm using the name because I can easily identify whether the network is host or the no network. So here you can see one container is running. As there is some limitation of the desktop or Docker where I cannot identify or run the port number, port 80 or the local host. So what I did, I put this container in running state. Now let me run the one more container on port 80. Docker run -- name new host machine -- network is equals to host and nginx colon latest. Let's see I can run or not, because I already run one container on port 80. Let's see. I can find the error that port number 80 is already been used. Right here you can see. Why? Because in one of the console we already used the port number 80. Now I'm trying to use this port number again. So it shows the port number 80 is already being used. So this is the example for host where you can create or where you can just run the container port number directly from the external using host machine. So in this example, you can see I have the container with the 5000. In external, I can use using 5000 port number where I didn't require to map my external port with the internal because I am using network as a host. So this is the way to use all three different network driver. Now if I need to create a new network, so before that I'm just closing this. And now if I run the command again, I can. Container is already there. Let me docker container prune. So all the stopped container will be removed. This command is used to remove all the stopped container. Okay, now let me. So here I can run the command because I have already close the existing port number. Okay. Now our next is create a new network with the bridge driver. So before that I need to validate network ls. Now let me create a new network. Docker network create and let's say bridge network 1. Okay, now let me run this command. So here you can see there are two bridge network. One is bridge and second one is bridge network 1. So when you create a new network, you can use simply bridge driver. Now if you want to create a new network, create a new container with bridge network 1, so you can run the container like bridge, network one, and I'm also putting this container in detached mode with bridge network. Any spelling mistake? Bridge. Docker network ls. Docker run -d --name. Machine --network. Let me copy the name nginx like this. Okay, there must be some spelling mistake. Docker ps. So now I can see front end back end is running. New machine is also created with the bridge network one. Now let me enter into backend because I have add IP utils in my backend. So docker exec -it backend /bin/bash. Okay, currently I'm in backend machine. Now let me check the private IP of new machine, which is a part of our bridge network one. So let me check docker inspect and new machine. The private IP address is 172.19.0.2. Here you can consider this network has been changed. Let me ping. It should not work. Reason? Because both are the different bridge network. One is 172.17, second one is 172.19. Now let me check 172.17. 0.2, it is a private IP of address of our front end machine here. So using different bridge network, you can isolate your communications between one container to another using bridge network. So for that, you need to create a new bridge network and configure within your container. So hope you guys find a valid session with Docker networking. Thanks for your watching this video. Kindly subscribe the channel and add your valuable feedback in comment section. Thank you very much.